What is the crack, ladies and gentlemen? It's Gibboeire here with another episode of World of Warcraft in the Kronos 2 server. How y'all doing? Alright, so the last time I stuck stuff up for sale on the auction house, it was basically everything else I hadn't sold and a couple of more of the cloaks. And we've sold stuff. I get the feeling I put that up for too cheap. Fuck. Well, 10 silver, it's all good. 50 silver is pretty fucking sweet. 50 silver, so that's a gold. Gold and a half. 2 gold. 2.5 gold. Shitty. Don't eat the meat. You might get hepatitis C. What the fuck? Sell the shell. It's probably worth 0.00 American spend. Cheers here. You're gonna love the guy. Keep it up, bro, Tato. You're fucking brilliant, dude. Thank you so much, sir. That message is fucking hilarious. I don't know. Should we eat the meat? Here we go. So we've got 50 silver. Another 50 silver. Another 50 silver. So let's just keep this 50 silver train going here. Okay. There's another 50. I'm only after realizing I should look at the names just to see who's been buying them. Fucking don't get hepatitis C. Eat the sell the shell. It's probably worth it. Thanks very much, bud. I really appreciate it. Again, people, you don't have to send me gold. Again, while it is highly appreciated, I realize it's quite hard to make it on this game, especially in vanilla, because vanilla being vanilla. I am very, very appreciative of it, but you don't have to. Okay? Thank you, though. Thank you so much. I'm not selling this clam. I'm keeping it. I'm keeping my hepatitis C clam. Until it, clan? My clan of hepatitis C. Right, we need to kill shadow mages, do we not? Who's Nagaz? They're in Strand, Brad. I know that much, but I don't remember seeing a Nagaz. He must have been up there. Once we do that, we should ding 35. And while you did get my blind spell as well, that's going to be useful in this area. And then I'm probably going to head to Stranglethorn. I'm feeling it. Because I reckon if I do all the Colonel Curzon quests and all that shit, that's all going to be rep for Stormwind. As opposed to working up here in the Arathi Highlands, where it might be like League of Arathor or some shit like that. I'm not really 100% certain. I may dick around with it for a little bit and just see which is the best way to go in terms of rep. But I reckon Stranglethorn, at least initially, for that first quest hub at the tip, is probably going to be the best way, at least initially, to get some quick rep for fucking Stormwind. But you never know. Maybe Arathi Highlands, like, there is a big fucking alliance kind of refugee point there, or refuge point. No, it's refuge. Ooh, hello. Is it me you're looking for? I look at he's popping down the earth bike. He's just like, he's gonna fucking kill me! Oh, God. Is he heartstoning? No, he's not. Oh, he's healing. I'd say that freaked him out. I'd say that I got him. I got him good. I'm very impressed with myself there now. I hit him by accident the second time. I didn't fucking mean to. I think I was still spamming the fucking Sinister Strike key. That must have been what it was. But I'm chuffed. What was I fucking talking about there? Shit. Yeah, rep. Arathi. Yeah, refugee point. Or refuge. Not refugee. That's what I was saying. Yeah. I mispronunciated the word Z-ated. But anyway, that's probably going to be the way we go. Again, nothing set in stone there. Not 100% certain. We'll tinker with it until I find the most appropriate course of action. Don't aggro. Be nice. Be good. Okay, anyway, I'm going to be back in a minute once I get my way up to Strandbrad. I don't think there's too much further to go. I think we're pretty much nearly there. So anyway, so we're nearly at Strandbrad here, but I need to talk then about kind of the cloaks and how I'm going to continue production of them in order to fund my mount. So 5 pieces of heavy leather, whatever they retail for, a piece of heavy leather can retail for anywhere between 5 silver to 10 silver on the auction house, currently anyway. When you think about it like that, that's how much they're going for. My nose is so fucking itchy. When you think about it like that, well, here, bud. Well, I'll fucking kill you, I guess. When you think about it from that point of view, that standpoint, you have to be generating that much, at least, to cover the cost of the construction of the item that you're selling. That's just the basic economics of it. So at the moment, I've seen them going, the cloaks, that is, going for as cheap as 30 silver.
It's too far away. It's too far 30 away.
Silver. I gotta loot this fucker. Which means that you could potentially be losing money by selling them. By creating them. People need them. There is a demand for said cloak. So what I've been doing, if you haven't been watching the previous episodes, is whenever I go to sell them, I buy any cloaks that are currently on the market, which means whoever put them up for whatever is going to get their money for them as well. Yeah, which is a good thing for them too. I buy whatever cloaks are on the market, and then I put everything back up for sale, including my ones that I've created, and I sell them for an increased margin. The logic being is that I don't want to lose money by creating and selling this item. I want to generate a profit so I can fund my mount. At the same time... Oh, fuck it. We have an improved ambush now as well, so... Hey. Head over here. Blade flurry. Jesus Christ, I couldn't find it on my fucking keyboard. I tired of this nonsense. Yeah, so do I, bitch. Let's go. Boobity boom boom. Kick. Yeah, get kicked, you motherfucker. So that's going to be the plan, is that I'm going to continue doing that anyway for the next short while. I may increase the price yet again. People need them. Like, they have to have them to complete that quest. If they don't have it, they can't complete that quest. And you do get a quest item out of it, but people don't complete that quest for the quest item. They complete that quest because they want experience and they want to get rep. And that's the logic to it. And they may think that there's a further part of the quest. Oops. They may think that there's a further part to that quest, like a kind of a fucking further part of the chain, even though there isn't. So, we can work on... Oh, fuck, that would have been nice. Woo. Hey, bro. You want to chill the fuck out there? Oh, here's a Shadow Mage again. And there's like a bazillion fucking syndicate people here. Oh, we need to not be in here. Yeah, there's a Shadow Mage. That's fucking wonderful. But there's like a bazillion syndicate cunts in there. I really don't fancy tangoing with that. So let's get the fuck up out of here. Right. Let's try the big building. Okay. There's no Horde player here today, so that is going to make this substantially easier. I say that like it's going to be easier. It's not going to be easier. This is a fucking hard little spot to fucking quest in. I think Nagaz is in here, if I'm not mistaken. Damn, I'm hungry. I need to go nibble some food. Okay, here's the Shadow Mage. Get shipped. Ah, shit, I didn't want to pull that one. I've done this poorly. Okay, it's fine. I gotta take a couple of hits here. But it's okay. Oh, shit, please, no. Okay, I may have to vanish out of this one. Okay, no, I dinged. That actually worked out quite well. Kick it. Yeah, now. Eventually they will go and then they won't be able to cast things at me anymore. Okay, that ding definitely saved our bacon there. Look, by one experience. Get fucked, mob. Get fucked. There you are. Drop on the floor. Because you don't care no more. No more. I don't know where I'm going with that. I shouldn't rap. That was my experience. That was my entire presentation of my rap skills there, by the way. Deal with it. Wonderful. Okay, that's two Shadow Mages down. Two Shadow Mages. We need two more. We do know the one is one in there, but there's two invisible guys and a wizard with them. And I'm a delicate flower. Oh, yeah. Wait. Ooh. Let's spend this point. Oh, finally, we can increase our... I think that's our primary one there, right there. This... Increase your skill with sword and fist and daggers. That's good. This is better, for at least initially. I will take the other one as well, eventually. But first I'm going to put points into that. Ooh. Dodge. Where will we find Nagaz, I wonder? It did say Strambrad, so I reckon he is in here somewhere. Whoop. Maybe down in the basement. Hmm. Joys of being a rogue and just dodging past all this shit. Like, if we were at... like, a different class, we wouldn't have this option. Like, we would have to fight our way through all of this, even when we were looking for them. You see, whereas I can just kind of poke in and around and actually look for the mobs I need. Shadow Mage? Syndicate Wizard? Ah, shit. Blows. But you see, we'd be after battling our way through all these mobs, which is also a good thing. So you get drops, you get loot, you get experience, which is all good. All very good. But you also have a massive time sink in terms of you have to put all the time into getting into this place and then not necessarily get the reward that you want. Shit. Right. So there's these two that we've killed. Pretty much. Oops. That scared the shit out of me. There may be one that spawns in here. There's not. Shit. Right. There's not that many of these mobs. There's like one there. One up in this building. One in this building. And where's this Nagaz fella? Hmm? Hang on and I read the quest. In the uplands where the syndicate is strongest. Oh, okay, yeah, no, it's a whole other area that I'm supposed to go with, because I remember seeing the tents that they had down here. Alright, so Nagaz and these Argus Shadow fuckers must be up here. This makes more sense. The Syndicate have sentries now? Well, fuck you, Syndicate Sentry. Sounds like a band. Syndicate Sentry. Okay, there's probably going to be a few of them in and around here. My concern now is that they're going to be so closely clustered together that it's actually going to become quite difficult to kill them. We need to keep an eye out for a Nagaz feller. Hmm. Oh, this is looking like a construction of some sort over here. Make my way that way. Fuck off, line. You don't know me. Alright, there's more tents down here. More tents here as well, by the looks of things. Yeah. There's syndicate saboteurs, there's fucking sentries, there's some shadow mages. This is looking a bit more base campy. Meh. We'd have to kill a fair few mobs there just to kill one shadow mage. That ain't ideal. Okay. Oh, fuck, I don't see a Nagaz. Make a nuke her and then fucking vanish. Like, that's a strategy we can go with, but... fucking seriously? Don't see me. Really? I think I saw something there in the distance, an Alliance player. Maybe mistaken. I'm gonna back the fuck up a wee bit and just pull them with me. But you know what? Here, look, we'll clear these two mobs out anyway. We'll make our way over to the, oh, shit. That's not good. We'll make our way over to that Shadow Mage now in a minute, and then, we'll work with that. We're gonna have another one coming in here now in 2 seconds. I'm gonna pop Evasion. Oh, no, they're gonna rail me over from afar. That is not good. I'm not going to be able to do shit all about that, so I'm going to run. And then if they get much more DPS on me, I am going to vanish. Line of sight there to me advantage. Oh, yeah, we have to leave. Okay, well, whatever. Now it happens. It's fine. It's okay. Chill, Winston. I reckon our fucker we want to be killing is down here. The blatant racism in the chat at the moment is fucking crazy. Okay, Nagaz, doo-doo-doo-doo. These are some pretty beefy mobs, like level 30-odd there and all. That's shit I don't want to be tangling with. Fuck. No, there's more tents over here. I'm gonna go keep looking for this fucker, and I will be backing him up. Oh, it's a human rogue. Okay, Grant, right. Alright. Anyway, I'll be back in a moment once I find a... Now, I've not found Nagaz, but I found a Baron Verdus. And I wonder... member of the Argus Wake. Huntsman, they must be a threat. Right. This is a Buildaneer. I can check out that Buildaneer. If not, it's probably that Baron, and he'll probably turn into Nagaz. He's probably like a demon or some shit like that. I don't know. We'll see. Anyway. Okay, we found Nagaz. He is in this building, and he's level fucking 40. Right, that's going to be a problem. I suppose the best bet how to proceed from here would be to...
That ability is
basically start killing stuff in front of this person, and we might ask this person to join us in a group, potentially. See if we can take this fucker out. And then on the way back, I'll pick up the... I'll pick up the other ones as we go along. I don't want to use any cooldowns on this shit. Nagaz is level 40, so Nagaz is going to be a tough cookie. Thank you. Okay. Right. Now let me think. I should probably eat. Okay. See, that person's level 37. Like, that person's going to have a real hard time at this as well. Like, this is a tricky spot we find ourselves in. Okay, and that person is fucking home as shit, and is getting attacked, so, let's get them stones on. Okay. Okay, let's get this guy on the dead, and then we'll work out where we're going from here. This is probably going to be substantially hard, so I am going to drink a Rumsey Black Label. And add another 15 stamina. Okay. Combat book. Yeah. Cool. Right, so I have a Rumsey Black Label in me, so that gives me 15 stamina. I have 32 stamina from her power of fortitude, and I have my two poisons on as well. So we nearly have 2k health. We're in a pretty good, strong position here now to be able to hopefully manage this situation. We'll see. Have faith. I'm going to create a silk bandage as well, just so I have all my possible options in terms of dealing with the situation at hand. I'll pop my head back in and around here, and if there's any more of these assassins that I can fucking clear out, I will do so. Gaz. Is he a member of the Horde, or what's the fucking deal? I don't see any more of the invisible dudes. Here, there is a worn wooden chest there. Okay, let's rock this shit. Oh dear. It was possible to pull that mob without pulling him? Oh, that's fucking awesome. That's just made the whole job like a bazillion times easier. I don't know if I'll out DPS this person. So I think my primary role in this matter is just going to be to keep this thing fucking stunned, and that person can just land all that DPS, and I'll just stop that fucker from doing damage to us. Okay. Ooh-hoo. Let's fuck up Nagaz. Let our compatriot here drink, and then on the way back I will kill the Shadow Mages, so that way it's not so hard on us. You know what I mean? Like, there's no point in killing 20 mobs if I can just kill one or two in Strandbrad. Like, take the easy option. Why make it hard on ourselves? Hopefully we get some serious Stormwind rep here now as well. Another 500 would be pretty sweet. Okay, go nuts. Here we go. Oh, a fucking mob has just respawned right next to us. This is seriously bad juju. Okay, hang on, I'm gonna pop Blade Fury straight away. And I'm gonna use my Viscerate straight away as well, because I reckon that this guy ain't gonna be alive for much longer. Here we fucking go. Right, grand. We have this well managed. So, fast respawn, right? We only killed that about 60 seconds ago. Get that stunned. And boom, nailed it. Let's loot Nagaz and we get his head. And let's loot this wooden chest, because I reckon this is probably a quest item. Shit, /P. Oh, shit.
I can't do that.
Chest inside for two item.
Damn.
So there's another quest. It's just going to give us a little bit more of experience. Probably rep as well. Oh, shit. I clicked off and I lost all my combat points. I'm so fucking upset. Damn. Okay, and we'll get out of this here place now. Okay, grand. No, whoops. And sprint! Fuck all, y'all. You ain't gonna catch me. You saying Bolt ain't got shit on this! Now, I'm gonna kill myself a couple of Shadow Mages along my way here. I might be able to nab one or two just on the easy. Easy mode. Now, hang on. Let's just take this here quest and have a read of it. So we have to bring it back to... Chatted with a spell right now. So the one word at the top apparently is the cipher button that just says Nagas. Well, that's great. This Baron Vardis, who are you? What is your purpose in all of this? What is your complicity? I'm uncertain. Questions that need answers. Back to Strand, Brad, so we can kill the shit! I think I killed this guy already, but. Eh, hey, fuck it! Swag! Swag! Kick him and then drag him over so that way our DPS is now affecting the two of them. This one's dead. Dead. Okay, there we go. That's 3 of 4. We need one more. I'm sure we can find someone somewhere in over the rainbow. We'll find one somewhere and we'll fucking kill him fairly easily. Hopefully we didn't aggro another mob. We did. I'm not out of combat. Fuck you. Let's pop an evasion, just because we're at a delicate point in our life here, and it could be quite easy for one of them to do a substantial amount of DPS to us, so. Get this on the shibbity shank. Now, done. Dead. Giggity. Loot. Successful. Right, one more. One more! There's one! There's one, I'm eating Reese's Pieces, deal with it. You don't know me. Okay. Watching this guy, I'm afraid he might... There we go. Easy money, easy life, easy game. Okay, Grant. I'm gonna make my way back to South Shore now, and we're gonna hand this quest in. So, and here we are arriving back into the wonderful sunny South Shore. Right. Two quests to hand in. The Dark Council and Ensorcelled Parchment. Did I pronounce that right? In source. Mr. Dibbs. It is Mr. Gibbs. How are you, sir? I have quests.
Greetings.
I have questions that need answers. Answers that need questions. I'm afraid I lack the notchiness, master. You're going to make me go back to Ironforge again. Fuck. Right. Okay.
Be careful.
Back to Ironforge. But more to this shit. Did we get experience there? No, we did not. Fuck it. Or did we? Wait. Hold on. No, I gained 1100 experience, which is good, I guess. It was rep that I wanted. Experience we can get. Gratuitous amounts of it. That's not a concern. Rep. Rep is a concern. I want this done by 40. I killed this fucker, so you should give me Stormwind rep. You gave me 275. I killed a level 40 orc and you gave me 275 rep. You're a bit of a dick, Henry. You're a bit of a fucking dick. Level 60, elite.
King's honor.
Fuck you, Henry. Fuck you. Yeah, that's it. You heard me. What are you going to do about it, huh? 40-55 fucking guard. Fuck you, Henry. And your fucking elite fucking thing that goes around your... Fucker. Right, okay. We have to go to Ironforge, apparently. And then we might be going to the Arathi Highlands. I get the feeling this could potentially be part of a quest chain, so I am actually going to go fly to Ironforge and just see where this quest chain leads us. So once again, I don't care that they're full of sugar. This is like the nicest shit I've ever eaten. Like this is... many grams is in this? There's 113 grams, so... in every 113 grams, there are 11.2 grams of protein, which is good for a snack. There's a lot of fat in it too. Because again, you know, peanut butter is fatty and all that shit. And then of course... there's 62 grams of carbs, of which 52 grams is sugar. Nice. that's not good for you. That's not good for you. But, meh, you can't eat the good stuff all the time. You are going to eat shit stuff. I suppose as shit stuff goes, There is 11 grams of protein in it, I guess. Fuck it though. Why not? Wait, there is 2,000 calories. Am I reading this wrong? Yes, I am. There's 500 calories in 100 grams of this stuff. Okay, yeah, right. Get starting to freak out there for a second. An entire day's worth of energy supply is contained within this orange box. Reese's to sponsor me and send me fucking chocolate all the time. That'd be a great idea, Reese's. Hope you're listening. Nice one. So, you know, I'm sitting here and I'm just chilling. I get a knock on my door. Donut. Today is an eat the shit food day. And of course, the not optional scalding hot cup of tea. Scalding hot. Okay, right. We'll take it easy on that for a minute before I burn my fucking taste buds off. We're gonna sprint because why not? We got it. It's on cooldown. It's cool. 3.5 minute cooldown. Cooldown remaining 4 minutes. Can anyone else see that? I have a 3.5 minute cooldown, and the cooldown apparently is 4 minutes.
Well met.
Hey, decipher this shit.
See you soon.
Oh, phone's ringing. Jesus Christ. Why does Break everyone ring me when I'm doing this shit? Wait, oh, wait, oh, was there more to the quest or what's the crack? Did I get more? No?
Safe.
Alright, there's an ultimate quest, so that worked out.
Be good.
Right, is that it? Right, Crom, are you gonna tell me to fucking do shit?
What can I do for ya?
Alright, that's another Alderman quest. Okay, we're getting lots of quests here anyways. This is all fucking good. I must be coming up to a level that I can do Alderman. And let's have a chat with the Reclaimer fucker here now and see what he wants to let me know. Reclaimer. Oh, that's a Halo reference.
What's
hey,
that
hey, 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 stay there. No, I'm not going to the fucking Desolus. We've spoken already. You're a jerk. Right. What else can I get done now in this episode? We have no heavy letters, so I can't make any more of the things. Which kind of blows. But, meh. Yeah. Now where do we go? So I guess we go back up and we go to Arathi now is going to be the next best. So, Goshek Farm. Quay and Killalori in the Arathi Highlands. So I'm going to fly my way to Arathi and we're just going to see. We're going to test the waters and see what it's going to look like in terms of questing. And then, we'll go from there. So, okay, so here we are in Arathi. So we have this worth its weight gold.
For the Alliance.
Which I will read now in a moment. Mara's Cowl. I believe these are all Stormwind quests as well. So I think we're in the good. Captain Neal's. Norfolk Manor. So that's more of the same shit that we've been dealing with so far. Now, I don't think there's any low levels that potentially hang on. Oh, well, here's a supply officer. What are you got, friend? Shit that I can't buy. Okay, grand. He has a quest for us to go in and capture some shit in Arathi. You know, the usual shit that they give you. Okay, I think we're actually pretty good here now. What do you got? You might have, like, recipes or something that I might want. No. Actually, no. It's good. If that was agility, that was fucking perfect. That was so cool. But, it's not. So, get up. Right. Goshek Farm. Goshek Farm is what we're looking for. Northfold Manor. Right, where is this? They say that like I know. Huh. In Northfold Manor. We have divided our once grace in each man. It must be in and around here somewhere in between. This is we are this level for this area as well. No, so like this is where we're meant to be. I'm gonna pop a sprint. It might be this. So hold on. Goshek Farm. I actually wouldn't know now, to be honest with you. I'm not really 100% certain of this area. I'm gonna make my way over to this because I reckon it's this. We need to find some Witherbark fellers as well. These are elementals. Right, you see, I'm not overly familiar with this area at all. So apparently there's a manor of sorts. That could be it. That may well be it, actually. Yeah, I reckon that is it. I reckon that's going to be something else. I don't know where to find this farm. Okay, so this is kind of a really new area to me. Like, I'm not really familiar with the quest lines here at all. Cup of tea. There is, however, a signpost in the distance there, so we're going to have a look at that and see what the crack is in terms of where we're going and what we're doing. And then once we figure out where we're heading, we'll start bashing out these quests and see how we get on with them. We have a couple of elites there as well. That's Stormguard, Thandalspan, the Wetlands, and that just says Hillsbred Plains. Okay, grand. Not really much in the way of direction, so I reckon this is the manor that it was speaking of. Right up here. So we will make our way towards it. No, that is the way into Hillsbred. Now I'm not so certain. Northfold Manor. So it's probably to the north. Territory between us. So it's saying territory between here. Could it be here? I know, because it's... I don't actually know, to be honest with you. I'm unsure. This might be it here, actually. This is looking like a manor of sorts. Again, he says with great trepidation. This is it. I'm going to wrap this episode up here, because we are just after hitting a half an hour. Hold on. Let's just see what the crack is. Nordfold Manor. Okay, this has been Gibboeire, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for watching this video. If you enjoyed watching this video, please consider leaving a like down below and possibly consider subscribing to the channel. Consider subscribing to the channel. If you don't want it, it's okay. It's fine, but it does help me out a lot and I would really appreciate it. It lets me know I'm doing a good job and it helps the channel grow and expand. And then I'm going to put more effort in and then it gets funnier for you guys. And then I get gold and then I can get all the hookers that I'll ever dream of. Pretty much the only reason I do this. Okay, if you have any comments, questions, concerns about anything in this video, like, why can't I loot this plant? Why? Because prejudice. Or am I going to be able to kill that 36 under? Find out in the next episode. Thanks for watching. Danny!